supply chain is facing. Let's talk about those. So, do you manufacture in different countries? So that's a challenge, because we have to make the product flow, whether it is in semi-finished form, whether it is raw material form, from one country to another country. This flow itself across borders has its own peculiarities in terms of the legal requirements, in terms of the import-export, the vagaries of the weather. If that gets bad, then the flow gets disrupted. So, manufacturing in different countries is a challenge in that most supply chains face, if there are that big. The next would be being able to control the quality and the safety of the product. Many times you would have heard of safety recalls, especially in the automobile industry. Or in the food industry, we find that the product is recalled and is scrapped. So those challenges are also there, and we have to see how to mitigate that. The only way to mitigate that is right at the design stage itself, that we are introducing so much of quality control that it's designed for quality rather than manufactured for quality. Nowadays, the lead times are reducing at such a rate that the consumer is wanting the product right now at his place. So you would have heard of technologies like 3D printing being evaluated to give the product to the customer at the place he wants. But that is one extreme. What I am trying to say is that the lead times are certainly reduced, not like waiting for 10 years for a telephone connection 20 years ago. And in order to mitigate those reduced lead times, you try to increase our inventory at a particular place. So that is another challenge, how to balance both of them. Having too many suppliers is also a challenge. So we have to look at how to consolidate my entire supply base. But when you consolidate the supply base, then you introduce another kind of risk, that you are at the mercy of one supplier, and if he gets some kind of disruption in his process, then you ultimately face the heat. Technology is evolving at such a high rate that what I am doing today as part of my product or as part of my manufacturing process or anywhere in the supply chain, a new product may come into play which has the capability of disrupting the entire supply chain. So, for example, earlier we would look at a lot of labor that would be employed in warehouses, but today we have entirely automated warehouses with very few people, and the entire pick to the dock is controlled by robots in warehouses. So I should be able to have access to that technology and able to deploy it at the right price. But I should be able to do it in such a time frame that if I don't do it and my competitor does it, so I lose out. The next would be how to plan and also strategize so that I do my risk management properly. Because of the very diverse and dynamic nature of the supply chains, it is not possible to plan the entire risk management in such a way that I am covered for everything. I can try to do it to the maximum. So that's again a challenge. Finally, there is a challenge which is across domains, across industries, is having the right talent in the right place at the right time, in the right amount. So we have to constantly think of being able to develop our people internally or source those people from outside so that I have the right talent to achieve my goals. So these are some of the challenges which every one of us faces in our supply chains. Thank you.